If you watch the Andy Griffith Show on a routine basis, or even if you don't, even if it's a casual glance at the show, you will remember the characters of the fun girls. The two girls were Daphne and Skippy, and they were two bachelorettes, and they were from Mount Pilot. And they would occasionally come to Mayberry just to mess with Andy Taylor and Barney Fife. Daphne's introduction was always a deep hello doll. And Skippy always referred to Barney as Bernie. They constantly created havoc in Andy and Barney's life. They created jealousy within the hearts of their girlfriends. But who really are these two characters that played Daphne and Skippy? Let's take a look at them in depth. Jean Carson was the actress that played Daphne. She was born February 28, 1923. She was a stage actress and a film actress. She also was in a lot of television stuff, too. She was born in Charleston, West Virginia. She first became interested in show business as a child, playing a bad little Indian girl. And at the age of 12, she got her first acting job. She earned $5 for a small part in a production of Carmen that traveled through her hometown area of Charleston, West Virginia. When she was in high school, she was voted the girl most likely to succeed as an actress. She actually told her mother that she was going to be on Broadway. After she graduated from high school, she went to Carnegie Mellon University in Pittsburgh. She did make it to Broadway and was in quite a few productions. She made her Broadway debut in George S. Kaufman's Bravo, a 1958 production. She then got into television and was in quite a few episodic television episodes. She was in The Twilight Zone. She was in The Ford Theater Hour. She was in the Peter Gunn series. And she was also in The Betty Hutton Show. Now, The Betty Hutton Show was a disaster for her. She did not like working with her at all. She just called her a foul-mouthed biddy. And she actually says it's the only acting experience that she didn't like throughout her career. On the big screen, she was in The Phoenix City Story, 1955, and she was in 1958's I Married a Monster from Outer Space. She felt like she was pretty typecast for certain roles. She said that she was the second woman, or the second tomato, the one that never got the man. Her last film role was in 1977 with Fun with Dick and Jane. Now, during the first half of the 1970s, she had a bit of a drinking problem, which really limited her acting career. She retired in the 1980s, except for a few performances in the Palm Springs area of some plays. And she really tried to mentor some of the community theater actors in that area. She later became sober, and she really tried to associate herself with that role from the Andy Griffith Show from many years before. And she went to different cast performances, conventions, and other meetings, and really liked writing back fans personally. If you go to the Andy Griffith Museum in Mount Airy and go down in the basement, and this is the area where you end up meeting Thelma Lou or Betty Lynn, if you wanted to sign autographed picture for you. There's a room down there that has a cabinet, a glass cabinet, that has a bunch of things from the Andy Griffith Show. And one of the things they have is her actual blouse, that polka dotted blouse that she wore during those scenes. In September of 2005, she had a severe stroke that left her just incapacitated. In November of 2005, she passed away at Palm Springs, California, from complications from the stroke. She was 82 years old. Now let's take a look at Skippy. Skippy was played by Joyce Jameson. Joyce was born in September of 1932. She was born in Chicago, and she graduated from UCLA with a Bachelor of Arts degree. She has a few Broadway credits to her name. One of them is Venus at Large, 1961, and the Billy Barnes People, 1961, too. Now, she began her film career in the early 1950s with numerous uncredited roles. She played a chorus girl dancer in the motion picture Showboat. She was also in 1953's Problem Girls and Tip on a Dead Jockey from 1957. In 1966, she starred as Abigail in the Elvis Presley film Frankie and Johnny. Now, she was also a very popular television actress. She has numerous credits to her resume. She was in The Dick Van Dyke Show, Gunsmoke, Stagecoach West, The Twilight Zone, McHale's Navy, My Favorite Martian, The Munsters, F Troop, The Rockford Files, and it goes on and on for quite a while. But her signature role has to be that of playing side by side with Daphne as the fun girls on the Andy Griffith Show. She also did a little bit of voice work. She did a cartoon series called The Joke Book. She was married to an actor and songwriter named Billy Barnes for many years. But she was also the girlfriend of the Man from U.N.C.L.E. star Robert Vaughn. And she actually guest starred in a 1966 role of the Man from U.N.C.L.E. in the episode The Dippy Blonde Affair. In Robert Vaughn's autobiography, which is called A Fortunate Life, he devotes a little bit of time to discussing Joyce's relationship with him and how much he loved her, but that it was basically a roller coaster ride. You never knew what you were going to get with her. He says that she suffered from depression and that she was an insomniac and she had to continually take medication to help her sleep. On January 16, 1987, she died at the age of 54. Her ashes were scattered at sea. For three episodes, Skippy and Daphne caused utter chaos in the town of Mayberry. You can't help but laugh every time you see them appear in a scene and see the distress that comes on Andy and Barney's faces. What great characters these girls portrayed. Thank you so much, Jean Carson and Joyce Jameson, for your roles as the fun girls. Rest in peace, girls. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll continue to chase the classics.